Welcome back to another very exciting tutorial here at the PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com. My name is Jesus Ramirez, and you can find me on Twitter at JRFromPTC. In this video, we're going to talk about the Photoshop toolbar and how you can customize it. The Photoshop toolbar is found here on the right, is this long strip of tools. And in Photoshop CC 2015.1, you can actually customize this toolbar. You can do so in two different ways. You can go into the edit menu and click on toolbar. You can also click on this icon here with the three dots and select edit toolbar. That's going to bring up the customized toolbar window, and it's actually very simple to use. It's drag and drop. You have your tools which update live as you adjust them here on the actual toolbar, and the extra tools column which contains the tools not found on the toolbar. So for example, we have the artboard tool, which you may not use very often, so I can click and drag that out. And now this tool is no longer found in the toolbar. You probably didn't notice it because it was nested under the move tool. Notice that the move tool does not have the triangle icon on the corner here, like the other tools, which means that there is no tool nested underneath. I can click and drag the artboard tool back under the move tool, and we get that triangle back, which means that this tool is now nested under the move tool, but I don't want that. I'm going to click and drag that out. And I'm also going to make other adjustments, like maybe removing the magic wand tool and maybe the slice tool and several other tools I don't need. Now, I'm not going to go through the entire list just to save a little bit of time, but you get the idea. You can also create new sets of nested tools. For example, maybe I want to have the spot healing brush tool in its own section. So I'm going to click and drag that out in between two sections. And now this tool is on its own. You can see it here, spot healing brush tool. And I can nest different tools underneath it. For example, the pencil tool. With the customized toolbar window, you can also choose which icons to display on the toolbar. For example, this the three dot icon that we clicked on earlier, we can disable that if we want to, and it's no longer here. We can also get rid of the foreground and background color, but I wouldn't do that. The quick mask mode and the view modes. So you can choose which buttons you want to have enabled or disabled. I'm going to enable all of them. When you're done, you can click on the done button, or you can save it as a preset to load this configuration into another computer. For now, I'm just going to click on the done button, and my toolbar has been changed. Another new feature that is very powerful that you can use the customized toolbar for is with custom workspaces. For example, you might be working in Photoshop in a very specific area. Maybe you're retouching or doing 3D or designing a logo. And for some of those tasks, you may have some tools that you use often and others that you rarely use. So you may want to have a custom toolbar for that. Let me show you how to create a custom workspace alongside a custom toolbar. To do so, first, find a custom workspace that is very similar to the one that you want to create. You can click on the workspaces drop-down menu here. And in this example, I'm going to create a workspace to help me with my photography. So I'm going to click on photography, and this could be retouching or anything like that. So I'm going to click on photography here, and it's going to change my panels. And I'm not totally happy with it, so I'm going to make some changes. I'm going to close the libraries panel because I don't really need it for my photography. I will just open one photo and work on that. And also when working on photography, I might have adjustment layers. So let me select the layer and create an adjustment layer. The layer is not that important, but I do want the properties panel to come up, and I want that to be available to me at all times. So I'm going to click on the properties panel and drag that above the layers panel. So now I have my properties panel there. My histogram is fine on top, the adjustment layers are fine there, and properties panel below that is good. Now I'm going to work on the toolbar. I'm going to go into edit, toolbar, and I'm going to click on reset to default, just so I can have the default toolbars, or even better, I'm going to click on clear tools, which is going to clear all the tools. Notice the toolbar is now clear, and I can just drag tools that I want to use for photography onto the toolbar. So I want to use the move tool and the quick selection tool, but I'm going to nest the lasso tool underneath that. Maybe I'll add the rectangular marquee tool and the elliptical marquee tool just in case. And maybe I'll add the crop tool and spot healing brush tool, healing brush tool, patch tool. And I'm just going to stop there for now because I want to save some time. But you can go through the entire list and decide which tools you want to add onto your toolbar. And I'm just going to finish it off with the zoom tool. So what I'm going to do now is also take advantage that within the customized toolbar, I can apply keyboard shortcuts. For example, maybe use a patch tool often. You can just click on the keyboard shortcut here on the right. If you notice, the right-hand side of each tool shows you the keyboard shortcut. If you click on it, you can actually edit it. Since this is my retouching photography workspace, I probably won't be using vectors. I can use maybe the path selection tool, which has a keyboard shortcut of A, and use that for my patch tool. So I can click on the patch tool and then press A on the keyboard. So now my patch tool's keyboard shortcut is A, and that's not going to bring up the direct selection tool. I can click on done. And if I press A on the keyboard, that's going to bring up my patch tool. Notice if I click on the tool here, the patch tool has a keyboard shortcut of A, patch tool. And just to show you how the patch tool works, I can select her mouth, make sure that we're on the actual pixel layer, click and drag that over to her forehead, and now her mouth is gone. Control D, Command D to deselect. Now I really like this workspace and I really like my toolbar. Now I have to save it. So I'm gonna go into this drop-down menu here on the top right and select new workspace, and I can name it whatever I want. So I just call it my photography because this is my photography workspace, and I wanna capture the keyboard shortcuts, the menus and the toolbar, and then I'm gonna click on save. Now, maybe tomorrow I have a different assignment and now I'm working on 3D. So I can click on the 3D workspace. Notice that the toolbar changes and so do my panels. And maybe I'll start working on my photography again. And I can click on my photography workspace and the tools are back. Now you're probably wondering about the keyboard shortcuts. Well, if I press A on the keyboard, I still have my patch tool. But if I switch into 3D and select a different tool like the move tool and press A again, now it selects the path selection tool. And if you're making adjustments into the toolbar, let me just make some adjustments here and I'm just going to restore it to default. So we're looking at the default toolbar here. And maybe I drag out the single row marquee tool and the single column marquee tool because I don't use them too often. And I'm working on my project, but now I find the need to use them. What do? Well, you can just click on the three dot icon here and notice that those tools appear there so you can select them. So the tools that you're not currently using in your main toolbar will appear under this button. So if I edit the toolbar again and maybe add the magnetic lasso tool and the magic wand tool, and I have a need for them, I can find them under this icon here. Also, when working with the custom panels, if you want to delete one, you can just click on delete workspace and you can delete your workspace that you created if you don't want to use it anymore. And just as a quick tip, if you accidentally delete one of the default workspaces, for example, the essentials workspace, and you want to get it back, you're going to have to go into the preferences. So you can press Control K, Command K on the Mac to bring up the preferences window. You could also go into edit, preferences, and there it is, Control K, Command K on the Mac. And under workspace, which is here on the side, workspace, you'll find these options here. And one of the options is restore default workspaces. Click on that, press OK again, and notice that the essentials workspace is back and it did not delete my custom photography workspace. And that's it for this tutorial. I hope that you enjoyed it and that you learned something new. If you have any comments or questions, leave them down below. If you enjoy the tutorial, don't forget to click that like button and share this video with a friend. If you haven't already, subscribe to the Photoshop Training channel now. Thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.